Hallelujah. 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 Because he himself was tested through what he suffered, he is able to help those who are being tested today. You can tell your soul, oh my heart, don't think that only you are going through this. You are never alone. Your God says, in order to participate in your pain and suffering, your God, though he was in glory, he came down to die for you, to be with you. He went through suffering. He went through loneliness. He went through humiliation. He went through being subjected to all kinds of pain, humiliation, misunderstanding, being forsaken, being misunderstood, being going through all kinds of pain and suffering, neglect. Those who trusted him, cheated him. Today, are you cheated in life? Are you broken in life? Are you disturbed in life? Do you feel that there is nobody to love you? There is nobody to stand with you? There is nobody to care for you? There is no one to love you? There is someone who has left his glory in order to be with you. Do you feel the enemy is overcoming you? Do you feel that you are trying to come up in life and again you are falling? The enemy is taken over you and you are crying, it is impossible for me. In order to destroy the enemy who has taken control over you, as 1 John chapter 3 verse 8 says, in order to destroy the enemy who has taken power over you and to free you from the hands of the enemy, the Lord Jesus himself has come down to be with you. Yes. Today, even those who have not sinned, they are thrown into the world which is full of sin, which is full of cheating world. He has come to be with you. Can you place your hand over your heart and call upon him? Call upon him. Lord, can you remember when you look down upon this earth, everywhere cheating and stealing, and to be with me you are coming. You are coming to be with me, Lord. That's why in the book of Hebrews, chapter 1, it is written, in times in the past, God spoke in a partial and various ways to our ancestors through the prophets. In the Old Testament, we find God never left any of his children. He sent prophets one after another to guide them, to lead them back to God. Yes, he never left them. Every prophet had two kinds of ministry. They were with these people and they saw the pain of their people. And they used to run to God and they cried to him, carrying the pain of his people to God and investing their time to God and listening to God. They brought back God's message, God's healing to his people, God's power and anointing for his people. On the one hand, they carried the pain of God's people to God, and they brought back God's healing and God's salvation, God's anointing, God's spirit to his people, to their people. Yes, God sent so many prophets, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, Amos, Hosea, all kinds of prophets, one after another. But verse 2 says, Hebrews 1:2, in these last days, he spoke to us through his Son, whom he made heir of all things, and through whom he created the universe, who is the glory of the Father, the very imprint of his being, who sustains all things by his mighty word. So Jesus is coming to sustain everyone through his word. What is the meaning of that? We read, God keeps in perfect peace whose mind is fixed on the Lord. God is coming. God brings his power to man. God brings his life to man. That is the one thing. But it's up to man whether he can. He is prepared to hear him. He is prepared to understand him. He is prepared to give himself to him. God has all of us, but very few have God with us. God comes to give himself to all of us. Very few give themselves to God. Every land receives the rain. The mountains don't produce crops. The thorny bushes don't produce crops. Those fields which are prepared, which are lost its weeds, which are prepared, they receive the crops. Yes, the Lord is coming. And those who are preparing, those who are willing to accept him, those who accept him, he gives them the peace of him.